चैप्टर 3 डेटा हैंडलिंग सी एक्सरसाइज 3.1 फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन यू हैव टू फाइंड अ रेंज ऑफ हाइट्स ऑफ एनी 10 स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ योर क्लास सो इट इज नॉट गिवन यू हैव टू टेक हाइट योरसेल्फ सो यू विल लेट हाइट्स विल बी इन सेंटीमीटर ऑफ 10 स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ आवर क्लास बी 125 127 132 133 134 136 138 141, 144 and 146 centimeter. You can take any height. So now you have to find range. So there is a formula for calculating range. Range, how you can calculate? Highest value minus lowest value. So first you will take highest observation. That is highest height is 146. So 146 you will write. Then lowest observation is 125. That you will write. Now range equal to highest value minus lowest value. So 146 minus 125, that is 21 centimeters. Now see, second question. You have to organize the following marks in a class assessment in a tabular form. These marks are given of students and you have to organize this in table form. Then you have to answer the following questions. So how you will arrange? See, you will take marks, then tally marks, then frequency. Marks are this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Then 1 marks, how many students have got? You will see from here 1 is coming 1 time only. So you will tally marks, you will draw 1. Frequency is 1 only. Then you will see 2, 2 is coming 2 times. So you will draw 2. Then frequency will be 2. Similarly, 3 is coming 1 time. You will write 1. 4 is coming 3 times. Frequency will be 3. 5 is coming 5 times. Frequency will be 5. 6 is coming 4 times. Frequency will be 4. Then 7 is coming 2 times. Frequency will be 2. 8 is coming 1 time. Its frequency will be 1. And 9 is coming 1 time. Frequency will be. Now students, in this parts are given. I have not written question. Question you will see from book. First part is given that you have to tell which number is the highest. So you can see in this 9 is the highest. So highest number will be 9. Then in second part it has been asked which number is the lowest. So lowest number is 1. You can see 1 is the lowest. Then third part is what is the range of the data. Range I told you highest value minus lowest value. So highest is 9 and lowest is 1. 9 minus 1 is 8. Then fourth part it is given, you have to find the arithmetic mean. Arithmetic mean, how you are finding students? There is a formula for this. Sum of all observations upon number of observations. You will find sum of all observations. Observations are given. You will find its sum, you will get 100. And number of observations are 20. So mean equal to sum of all observations upon number of observations. So 100 upon 20, you will get 5. So mean is 5. Now see, third question. You have to find the mean of the first 5 whole numbers. So whole numbers start from 0. First 5 whole numbers will be 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. Now mean equal to sum of all numbers upon number of numbers. You have to find 5 whole numbers are there. So 0 plus 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 upon 5. That is 10 upon 5. You will get 2. Now see fourth question from the book only. It is given a cricketer scores the following runs in 8 innings. You have to find the mean score. So mean score equal to total runs scored upon total number of innings. So 58 plus 76 plus 40 plus 35 plus 46 plus 45 plus 0 plus 100 upon number of innings are 8. You will get 400 upon 8, that is 50. Now students, see fifth question from the book. Table is given that shows the points of each player scored in 4 games. A, B, C are players and they have played 4 games. Their scores are given. You have to answer the following questions. You have to find the mean to determine A's average number of points scored per game. A's average number of points you have to find. So 14 plus 16 plus 10 plus 10 upon 4 games he has played. So 4 you will write. So 50 upon 4 you will get 12.5. Now in second part it has been asked to find the mean number of points per game for C. Would you divide the total points by 3 or by 4? Why? So to find mean number of points per game for C, we will divide total points by 3. Why by 3? Because C has played 3 games. You can see from table that in game 3 C did not play. So that you will not count. That's why 3. That's why you will divide by 3. Then third part, B played in all the four games. How would you find the mean? So mean you have to find out B score. That is 0 plus 8 plus 6 plus 4 upon 4. 18 upon 4, you will get 4.5. Now in fourth part, you have to tell who is the best performer. So the best performer will have greatest average amongst all. Average scores we have find. A's average score is 12.5, B's average score is 4.5, and C has played 3 games, so his average score will be less only. So you can see highest average score is of A. So that therefore A is the best performer. Now see sixth question. The marks out of 100 obtained by group of students in a science test are given. You have to find the first highest and lowest marks obtained by the students. So highest marks you can see from the, it is given that observations, you can see 95 marks are the highest. So highest marks are 95. Then you have to tell lowest marks are 39. Then second part, range of the, now in second part you have to find the range of the marks obtained. So range equal to highest value minus lowest value. So 95 minus 39, you will get 56. Now in third part you have to find mean marks obtained by the group. Mean marks equal to total marks upon number of students. Total marks you will find, marks are given in question and number of students are 10. You will get 730 divided by 10. You will get 73 marks. Now see seventh question. The enrollment in a school during 6 consecutive years was as follows. Enrollment of number of students are given. 1555, 1670, 1750, 2013, 2540 and 2820. You have to find the mean enrollment of the school for this period. So mean enrollment, sum of all observations upon number of observations. You will find the sum and it is for 6 years, so number of observations will be 6. You will get 12,348 divided by 6. You will get 2058. Now see 8th question. The rainfall in a city in millimeter on 7 days of a certain week was recorded as follows. Rainfall in millimeters is given on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday and Sunday. First part is you have to find the range of the rainfall in above data. So range equal to highest value minus lowest value. So 20.5 minus 0.0, you will get 20.5 millimeter. In second part you have to find the mean rainfall for the week. The mean rainfall equal to total rainfall upon number of days. You will find the sum divided by 7. So 41.3 upon 7, you will get 5.9 millimeter. And in third part you have to tell on how many days was the rainfall less than mean rainfall. Mean rainfall was 5.9 millimeter. So less than 5.9 millimeter in how many days? You can see from table it is for 5 days the rainfall was less than average rainfall. Now see ninth question. The height of 10 girls were measured in centimeter and results are as follows. Heights are given. So first you will arrange the heights in an ascending order. Then in first part you have to tell what is the height of tallest girl. So you can see from this tallest girl is 151 centimeter. In second part you have to tell the height of shortest girl. So height of shortest girl is, you can see 128 is the lowest number, so 128 centimeter. Then in third part you have to find the range. So range equal to highest value minus lowest value. Highest height is 151, lowest height is 128. So you will get 23 centimeter. Then in fourth part you have to find the mean height. So sum of all observations upon number of observations. You will get 1414, sum divided by 10. You will get 141.4 centimeter. Then in fifth part it has been asked how many girls have heights more than mean height. So you will see the height of 5 girls is more than the mean height. Thank you.